The blackwater ecosystem is a type of aquatic environment found in tropical regions, where the water has a dark, tea-colored hue. This color comes from tannins and other organic compounds released by decaying plant materials, such as leaves and wood. In these ecosystems, the chemical composition of the water and low light levels create a unique environment for many fish, plants, and microorganisms that have adapted to low nutrients and acidic water conditions. I will show you my blackwater ecosystem tank, which I created 150 days ago from its beginning to the present. Welcome to Peace of Nature. I chose a tank that is not too big for this ecosystem. The tank has a water capacity of 40 liters 10 gallons. For the bottom layer, I'm using organic garden soil that I collected from my own garden. I have never used fertilizers or pesticides in my garden, so I'm sure this soil is completely natural. I sifted the soil to separate it from any unwanted matter. I covered the soil with a thick layer of river sand. I created the decoration according to my preference using natural driftwood, grapevine, and stones that I collected from nature. I fixed these decorations together with superglue because they won't sink in the water right away. I made two entrances in the coconut shell, which is completely harmless to use in the aquarium. The first entrance is visible from the front of the tank, and the second entrance can be seen from the side of the tank. If the fish decide to make a nest here, I will have the chance to see what's happening inside. After placing the design inside the tank, I covered the river sand with play sand. Play sand is aquarium safe and very affordable. It doesn't alter the water parameters, and I really like its visual appearance. To make the tank look more natural, I'm enhancing the realism by adding stones of various sizes randomly. I'm also adding dried leaves and materials like alder cones, which are some of the most important components in blackwater ecosystems. Over time, these materials will break down and release tannins into the tank, which will yellow the water and create the environment that the inhabitants need. When adding water, I place a plastic bag over the decoration to prevent the arrangement from being disturbed. I use tap water that has been dechlorinated in my tanks. The tap water values may vary in each city. If you know the tap water quality in your area, you can use it in your tanks. I also took water from my tank where the Daphnia population is dense and added it to this tank. This way, we will have started the food web from the very first day. I added a small filter and a simple LED light in the tank. Blackwater tanks don't require very strong lighting. We can even use a regular bulb. As you can see on the first day, the water looks quite clear. The next day, the water turned yellow, but there was a slightly cloudy appearance. A few days later, the water in the tank reached the desired look. It's time to add the plants. In blackwater ecosystems, you generally don't see dense vegetation. There are some areas with many plants, but it's not very common. I won't be covering this tank with so many plants either. Since blackwater is slightly acidic and light intensity is low, it's not suitable for all types of plants. If you want to set up a tank like this, please research plant selection carefully. As the light intensity tends to decrease towards the bottom, it's best to choose plants that require low light. After adding the floating plants to the tank, our blackwater tank is fully ready for its story. A few days later, these small creatures began to appear in the tank. And day by day, they started to multiply even more. The name of these creatures are Daphnia. They often called water fleas are small freshwater crustaceans found in ponds, lakes, and slow-moving streams. They play an important role in the ecosystem, feeding on algae and bacteria and serving as a food source for many fish and aquatic animals. The main characters of our blackwater ecosystem are Bonnie and Clyde. Apistogramma cacatuoides is a popular cichlid species native to the Amazon basin in South America. They are known for their vibrant colors and elaborate fin structures, especially in males. These fish are quite small, reaching about 8 centimeters 3 inches in length, and thrive in warm, slightly acidic water conditions. We've set up this tank to mimic their natural habitat, allowing them to display natural behaviors and interact with their environment. As soon as the fish entered the tank, they started hunting the Daphnia. This helped control the Daphnia population in the tank. Live foods like this strengthen the fish's immune system and improve their breeding quality. Clyde is going in and out of every possible nesting spot inside the tank, and he is constantly courting Bonnie. However, Bonnie doesn't pay any attention to Clyde. Sometimes, until it's time for him to sleep, my cat and I stay up in front of the tank to watch the next stages of their behavior. One day, when I saw this scene, I was shocked. Bonnie had killed Clyde. In life, there is death as well. The death body of one living being becomes the food source for another. And this is crucial for the cycle of the ecosystem. These isopods are ready and waiting to consume and decompose the death body. They will eat the dead fish and return beneficial elements to the soil through their waste. As soon as the body was placed in the soil, the isopods began to break it down. This fish came into the world for a purpose, lived its life and died, but its role in the ecosystem is not over. Even in death, it's still part of the ecosystem and continues to benefit nature. It is now an eternal part of nature. There is life and there is death. And between these two, there is beauty and melancholy. The death body stayed in the tank for a few days, so I felt the need to do a water change. Bonnie continued to live in this tank alone for a long time. This period not only helped her gain better condition to be a healthier mother, but also gave her the opportunity to spend enough time alone with herself, facing her conscience. Weeks went by and I added a new Clyde to the tank. This Clyde is a bit younger than the previous one. As soon as Clyde entered the tank, Bonnie started closely monitoring him. I'm keeping a close eye on them. If there is any sign of an attack, I will immediately remove Clyde from the tank because I don't trust Bonnie. Although Clyde has just entered the tank, he's making very bold moves. He's putting on all his shows to win Bonnie over, displaying all the charm of his body. Due to the water changes, the color of the tank has gradually lightened, and I want to restore it to its original state. I added a few types of botanicals I collected from nature to the tank, and a few days later, the water turned yellow again. Their relationship is going well so far. I hope they grow closer, and we get to witness them raise their fry. I also share their updates on my Instagram account. I would be happy to see you there as well. If you liked the video and don't want to miss the next episode, you can subscribe and turn on notifications. Thank you so much for watching this video. Peace and love.